Right, now it's time to head over to the kitchen and find out more about the salmon recipe Mark is making. Salmon, the bacon of the sea.
Yeah, I think you've got something there.
Yeah, we've got beautiful salmon. So salmon's a great fish, you know, full of oil, full of flavour, nice richness. Yeah, and really good for you as well. So it can withstand like some, you know, great flavours, and we've got those here. So we're going to make a beautiful crust with some seaweed or nori. So this, we're going to get it crispy, crush it all down. We've got sesame seeds, a little bit of spice in there, and then we're going to sweat down some chilies, ginger, shallots and garlic as well, and that's all going to go on top of the crust, and then we're going to make a classic barbecue sauce, but a Japanese barbecue sauce, so it's a little bit different.
That sounds phenomenal, and a good day too, because there'll be people hunkered inside ready to cook up a storm today. So we'll come back and get all the tips and tricks to create this delicious salmon soon. Great to have you with us in the Becco kitchen for another incredible recipe from Mark, a crusted salmon, and we're using nori to crust it, amongst other things. So this is going to be delicious, isn't it?
Oh, it's going to be fantastic. Right, so you're going to start off, we're going to make the crust first. So we've got the nori in here.
Yeah.
So it's pretty much dried, but we're just going to put it in a dry pan and just get it a little bit sort of crispier there.
Okay.
And bring that flavour out as well. So you want to do that first.
So this is traditionally what we have around sushi, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. So I was thinking about it. This recipe is basically an inverted sushi.
Nice.
Cooked.
Okay, good. No, that sounds good. I got sucked into the vortex of YouTube last night looking at seaweed. It's quite fascinating, you know, the process and what you look for. There's white bits in your seaweed sheets, dead seaweed, haven't processed it fast enough, and all different textures and stuff.
You live an exciting life, don't you?
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I was like, oh, next clip, please.
Okay, you'll be foraging next for seaweed on the beach.
That's right. Big business, too.
Yeah, well, it is.
Right, so we're going to make the crust there. So I've got some peppercorns in there.
Yeah.
I've got a little bit of nori, but I'm going to show you how to do that in a sec.
Okay, cool.
And you can start crushing this.
Okay, I'll
some sesame seeds in there.
Yep.
Little bit of chili powder in there and a pinch of salt in there as well.
Okay, cool.
So that goes in there. So you can start grinding that down.
Okay, cool.
Right, so the nori, so it's nice and sort of, you know, it's dried out a bit, it's getting crispy, and then, you know, just give it a nice sort of fold it up and then give it a nice slice across. You get these nice little strips, which is all quite nice. And then I'm going to pop them in there as well. And you sort of, you know, you're going to grind it up, so that's going to sort of grind down a little bit. But then you're going to be left with these like little strips as well. So
right.
It's all about texture now, texture and flavour.
Oh yeah. Okay. Cool. Did you know that? This is a seaweed fact. There's different levels of saltiness in them as well.
Yep.
But when you go to buy seaweed, what they do in China is they have, like, say, 40,000 boxes in a room, and people go along and they taste it, and then they write down how much they're willing to pay for it, like an auction.
Oh,
and that's
really
how they get fair market value for it.
There's lots of different ones, isn't there?
Well, yeah, no, all different. And they roast them there on the spot just to see, you know, whether or not they're tasty and what salt levels they are, and the wax sheets. Fascinating.
Sounds awesome. Maybe we can do that as a segment.
There we go. Yeah, nice. Okay, so this is the crust for our salmon, and what are you doing
right
now?
So this shallots is going to be in the next part of our crust as well. So I've just got some shallots. So I'm just going to dice it nice and fine. And then I've got a little saucepan there with a smidge of butter in there.
Mark, smidge of butter. I mean, look at that. That sort of smidge. That's a lot.
It is if you're a chef.
Right, so I'm just going to dice the shallot up. Mm-hmm. Got a bit of garlic as well, so do the same with the garlic. Chop it nice and fine. And then I've got a little bit of chilli as well. And then we're just going to melt the butter, keep it on a nice medium heat, and then we're just going to sweat off the the shallots and garlic.
Okay.
And then add the chilli, and then we're going to add the nori mix back to it. You know, so you're just releasing those flavours of the garlic and shallot.
Oh yeah, so this.
So you don't want any colour, and you don't want to get it too hot. So
right.
just sort of sweat it down, and then we're going to mix it all together, and then we're going to start colouring the salmon in the next segment, and then we're going to put our crust on there, and then just going to pop it in the oven just to finish off. So you're going to get fantastically flavoured salmon, you know.
Right, and I can see that you're chopping up a bit of chilli there.
Thanks. Yeah, a little bit of chilli.
Yeah. I'm not a huge fan of chilli.
Oh, should I put it all in?
No,
I'll just stop there then, should I?
I'm hungry today.
Right, we've got a little bit of rice in there.
Yes.
So just some lightly salted water. Bring it up to the boil with the rice, pop the lid on, and then put it on the lowest heat, and then we're just going to cook that for about sort of 12 to 15 minutes, and then turn it off, let it steam. Rice is ready. You know, we'll just keep it nice and plain because we've got so much flavours on our salmon.
And while we're preparing all of this, do we leave the salmon out to room temperature, or do we keep it in the fridge?
No, so that's a good idea. So bring it out sort of about 10, 15 minutes before you want to cook it. It'll just relax. It'll just open up all those flavours as well. It'll be nice and soft, because we want to serve it nice and pink in the middle.
Right.
Well. Don't overcook it.
Nice work. I'm going to get on grinder in the break. And we'll finish off the salmon just after we catch up with Holly. So we need to finish off this nori crusted salmon. Chef Mark, how are we going?
We're good. So we just added the chilies. So you can see the shallots and garlic's just nice and sort of softened up. You're getting all those flavours coming out now. Right, now it's time to add your nori mix into there.
Okay,
give it a good stir. Cook it for about another minute, and then we'll pop it in the bowl to cool down.
Okay, nice. That smells really good too. Okay, cool. So now we use all the butter, soaking it all up.
That's it. See, look, you can't even see the butter now.
Yeah, that's good. The right amount, chef.
Exactly. Right, so nice pan here, little bit of oil, get it nice and hot. And we want to use a nice hot pan now. We want to sear the salmon, get a nice colour on both sides. Then we're going to put the crust on and we're going to finish it off in the oven.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so it's entirely up to you now. If you want, you can leave the skin on the salmon, you can get it nice and crispy, seal the other side, put the crust on the top side.
Yes.
Or you can take the skin off the salmon if you want, so you're just left with that. Just give it a nice colour on both sides, and then the crust. It's entirely up to you, whatever you want. If you want more texture, but we have got some texture from the crust, what we're doing, so it's quite nice to take the skin off. Right, really hot pan. Make sure the oil's hot as well. And what we're going to do, get the salmon, and you want to pop it in, pop it away from you, you know, so you don't splash your fingers because it's nice and hot. Pop two pieces in, and then we're just going to watch it. Nice colour, flip it over, take it out, put the crust on. Pop it in the oven. Right, as that's cooking, we're going to make a barbecue sauce now. So this is a Japanese barbecue sauce.
Busy today.
But this is really easy. This is great. And all these ingredients you probably should have in your pantry as well.
Cool.
So I'll give
ketchup.
Them to you. All right, so we've got some ketchup. So that's going to be the base of it.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some Worcestershire sauce.
Yep.
That goes in there.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of soy sauce.
Soy sauce.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, most of this you will have at home. You're right, vinegar. Nice.
And a little bit of sugar.
Yep.
Goes in there. And then we've got some Dijon mustard.
Oh, yeah, cool. Nice.
And a bit of mustard powder as well. Okay, so this is just a yellow mustard powder. So this gives you a nice sort of depth and a bit of a kick.
Nice.
You know, so you've got that vinegar in there as well, so it's sort of balancing off with all that sweetness in there. So you've got the sweet and sour, you know, you've got that sort of tomato-y flavour coming out, but then that's cut with the Worcestershire sauce. So all you want to do, mix it all together.
Yeah.
I just like to bring it up to the boil, just so it starts bubbling, just so you sort of dissolve all of those ingredients and give it a little bit of heat so they start infusing all together. Cool it down and eat it nice and cold.
Okay, great.
And a good tip as well, you can make this in a bigger batch and keep it in the fridge and put it on anything you want, really.
Brilliant.
So, there you go. Beautiful colour on the salmon.
Yeah, that's looking great.
Flip it over, and then going to get our crust. And then, you know, because we added that butter, you can just pop it in.
Yeah.
And just pop it on top, so you've got a nice, even crust. And then that's just going to go in the oven until the salmon is cooked.
I tell you what, I can smell that crust from here. Mixed with the salmon, it's going to be absolutely delicious. And quite easy to do, you're right, actually quite easy to do.
Very easy to do, you know, so we're doing this in real time, you know. Salmon's cooking, we've just made the crust, the sauce is ready, and the rice is cooking.
Everything's dissolved, looking good.
There you go, that's
fantastic, nice work. Ooh, I can't wait to start eating this. Looks great, mate.
Right, it's all finished now, so got the rice on the plate. Salmon goes on, and then a little bit of that barbecue sauce. Look at that, beautiful.
Oh, look at
God,
that.
I should have cooked more.
Yeah.
You really should have, Mark. You really should have.